Do you want to create your own social media community, but you just don't want to rely on Facebook groups, LinkedIn, Twitter, and all those other social media accounts where you're just competing with a bunch of groups? Well, this community creator is called Beam. And in this video, I will be making a review, so I will be talking about what I like and dislike about it. Now, if you're looking for something simple that's easy to set up, Beam might be the deal for you. But if you're looking for something to fine tune with a lot of settings and just make something really customizable, then this deal might not be for you. So what I'm gonna do in this video is we're gonna jump on it. I'm gonna show you how to set it up and how it actually looks and works. So let's go jump over to my desktop right now. All right, so I first want to talk about the deal that's going on right now because it starts off at $79 for the lifetime deal. So that means you pay once and use forever. If you find this video helpful, do consider using that link in the description. Now, what I like about it is that for the $79, you get unlimited users and you get unlimited storage. So that means you can have as many friends or clients or whatever you want to use your community for without having those limits. The limits that do come in play are these. For $79, you are tied to the professional plan. You get community level 50, one integration, one professional community, and up to 3 mods and admins. Team access 2, okay? I would recommend at least the double code, which is the premium plan. So it jumps to the next plan and you're tied to whatever update that plan has. So premium plan, 158. And community level up to 100, up to 3 integrations, 1 premium community, unlimited mods and admins, team access to 3, and you get custom gamification. So that's not available on the single code. So I recommend double code at least. If you're interested in this, you get all these options available up to 10 codes, which is pretty much expensive, but you get more limits. Okay, let's jump into the actual platform. Let's go first with the settings. Is it hard to set up? And it actually is not. It's super easy to set up because it's not so complex. It's a pretty simple platform. So you get an overview first of members' activity, active members and new members. In this case, it's just one because obviously it's just a demo video. Statistics, let's go to statistics. All right, let's wait for that to open. There we go. This is where we're going to view total members, new members, active members, members visits, average time spent on the platform, top members. In this case, it's just one. I created a member called Danny Lopez. And the retention rate, member activity, platform distribution, OS distribution, and member information, right? So we get all that info. Next is we have subscription. This is not included in the deal, and that's something I wish they do include it. So if you want to create a type of paid subscription to join the community, that's gonna cost you an extra, and that's gonna be a monthly or yearly price. It's not gonna be on the lifetime deal. And there's also code management. Next thing we have is the platform settings. Like I mentioned before, it's super easy to set up and that's something I like. The cons about it is that it's simple. So first off, we need to name our community, which I just called it SaaS community. The Beam domain, in this case, I called it saasmaster.beam.gg. Again, you can use your own custom domain, which is something I would recommend. You don't want to send someone to saasmaster.beam.gg. You want to send them to something nice like saasmastercommunity.com. I don't know, whatever you want to use it for. The tagline, I'm using the default one. The short description, just by default, we can edit these. The custom domain, if we want to set that up. The privacy statement, in this case, it's just default privacy statement. I haven't added anything to it. Again, terms and rules, we can change those. The branding settings, you only get 2 settings, which is the icon and the platform cover. Let me show you the platform, how it actually looks. This is the cover on the top. And this is the icon, okay? So pretty simple in that sense. You don't get other customizations for that apart from design colors. So these are the design colors. What you want to use it for your branding color, which is red, pink, purple, blue, and other shades of colors. You don't have a custom color selected. You have to choose one of those. And right now there's only light mode, but dark mode is coming and lights out also mode coming out. These aren't ready yet. And next thing we have is the user reactions. We can customize these. Right now, by default, these are the ones that are available, but we can change the icon for these and change what it says in case you want to use it for something else. Post categories. So these are the default categories and I can add more to these. Sub forums. If you want to create forums to separate categories, in type of form, well, you can create those also. And the platform visibility, is it gonna be public or private? Only members see content. Those are the settings for the platform. Now, let's go jump over to the platform to show you how it actually looks. This is the platform. Pretty simple and straightforward. On the top, we saw the cover, obviously add something nice. I just added something so you kind of see what you can add. On the left, we have our logo and we have the forums right here. I created these forums and it separates, I would use it as categories, and you can separate your posts through there. You have a search option here, and we have the option to view hot, image, new, and new post. If I want to create a new post, these are my options. Here we go. I can create a submitted post. It could be a text, image, or a poll. I can write a title, where I want to put it in which community, which is intended for. Like I said, you can use it as categories. And is it going to be general, Q&A, or idea? Remember, we can set those up. We can change these and make it more customizable in that sense. We can drop in the image here, the text that we want to add for the description, and we have all these settings available. You can post anonymously if you like. Now, I mentioned I would say what I don't like, and that's something that I wish we had an option to remove these if we don't want to allow users to post anonymously. So you want to have that option to allow or not to allow. And once you're done, you submit, and it's gonna look something like this. I just made a test post. This is me posting. It was 3 hours ago. Here's my handle, Danny Lopez. There's the image I've added, some heading, some description. I've added some reactions. I can upvote, downvote, and comment if I like. Now, if I want to comment, it's not gonna open it up as Facebook. You know, you comment and it stays on the same page. This one opens up the page and you comment here. I wish they kept it in the same section, so it just comments in the same place, but it doesn't do it that way. So something I dislike. We can have the options to edit and delete, since I am the user who posted this. I am not viewing this as the admin. This is an actual user. And next we have information about my profile. Wait for that to open. And there's things that it makes us incentivized. So for example, we're viewing here that we're in level one and there's 30 levels and there's things that, you know what, if I see this, it makes me want to post more. And that's the idea. People posting, commenting, and sharing and all of that makes this level go up. You have details as join date, browsing from, birthday, the badges. So for example, there's badges for a nice reaction, highly aggregable, and there's several things for different badges. And statistics for my profile, it's one submission, reply submitted, upvote received, and reactions received. So that's what we see on profile. Okay, but basically that is Beam. Like I mentioned before, it's a simple platform. If you're looking to create a community that's easy to set up and easy to manage because it's just simple, straightforward, people are gonna jump in and they're going to start posting, commenting, and reacting, this is the way to go. But if you're looking for something more customizable, more complex, then I'm surely that this won't be the deal for you unless you want to wait for them to implement more features. But as of now, this is what you're going to get. The price, it's a good price point because it's a lifetime deal. I mean, you're paying once for this and you're getting it. I think it's a pretty sweet deal for that. So like I recommended before, at least the double code, that's what I would get if I intend to have a community and if this is what you like, something simple. Well, there you go. That is Beam. If you guys want to grab that deal, the link will be in the description. It helps me out with a small commission and it helps me out make these videos. I thank you all for watching. My name is George. This is SaaS Master and I'll see you guys later.